Dear friends, welcome to another video. This is Nick from Educates TV, and today we are going to test this big 3.5-inch color TFT display for Arduino. Without any further delay, let's get started. A few weeks ago, I discovered this promising new display on Banggood.com, and I thought that it might be useful in some of our projects. The price of the display is very low for such a big display. It costs $10, and Banggood.com was kind enough to send me a sample unit in order to test it and share my opinion about it with you. As you can see, the display is big and it offers a resolution of 480 by 320 pixels. If I turn it around, you can see that it comes with pre-soldered pins for Arduino Uno, which is nice since there are not many big TFT displays that work with the Arduino Uno. At the back, we can also see that there is an SD card slot available. But there is also one disadvantage. This display needs a lot of digital and analog pins in order to work. So if we don't use the SD card module of it, we are left with 6 digital pins and one analog pin to use with other modules or sensors. If we are going to use the SD card module of the display, we are left with only 2 digital pins and one analog pin, which is of course very limiting. But we can always use the Arduino Mega board, which offers many more digital pins to work with. The display uses the ILI9481 driver and it works fine with the Adafruit libraries. I have loaded a demo sketch that is included in the library, and as you can see, the display is working as expected. It is not the fastest display I have tried, but for its size and resolution, it is a very nice display. Check this out. I have loaded another demo that is included, and it loads images from the SD card and displays them on the display. Great, isn't it? The old and slow Arduino Uno, which has only 2 kilobytes of RAM memory, is capable of driving and displaying images on a big color TFT display. In order to speed things up, I thought I could use the display with the fast Arduino Duo board, but unfortunately it does not work with it. It works fine with the Arduino Mega, but it does not work with the Wemos D1 board since it only has one analog pin and the display requires 5. Let's now see the software side of the project. First of all, we have to download the appropriate library for the display. You can find the library files on the product page on Banggood.com. All we have to do is to install the library and load any of the examples that are designed for this shield. Since the display uses our familiar Adafruit libraries, we can easily build impressive projects. I have developed a single program just to demonstrate how easy it is to use the display thanks to Adafruit libraries. It uses some of the basic functions in order to display text and simple graphics. You can find the code of this simple example in a link in the description of the video. As a final thought, I think that this display is a very useful one if we want to use a big display on an Arduino Uno or an Arduino Mega. The low cost of it, the good library support and the ease of use make it ideal for all Arduino users, from novice to experts. I am going to use this display soon in a project. I am going to create a simple and low cost information display system for the car of one of my friends. I would love to hear your opinion on that display as well. Do you find this display useful? Do you plan to use it in any of your projects? Please post your comments or ideas in the comment section below. Thanks! If you are new to the channel, you may not know that my day job is developing Android games, and 5 months ago, I published a new game on Google Play Store. It is called Quiz of Knowledge, and it is a quiz game that supports 5 languages and it is completely free. If you like quiz games, I am sure you are going to enjoy this one. If you wish, you can download it by clicking here or in a link in the description of the video. Thank you! If this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribed. In this channel, I post videos about do-it-yourself projects every Saturday. I love making things and I believe that anyone can make things. Anyone can become a maker. That's why I created this channel, in order to share my knowledge with the community and learn from the community. I hope you will join us. Until next Saturday, watch, learn, build.